enjoyed escaping your own past time.
Not my only, but one of my most enjoyable. I've had a very fine day, as you probably have guessed.
Yes, how do your authorities feel about this? It's a comparatively dangerous trip.
Well, the surprising thing is that all seven of us water ski. We have a site where we work, which is near the water, both at Langley, which is our home base, and the Cape Canaveral.
Do you think they encourage this for any reason?
Well, one of the things that's most important to us is to keep in physical trim. And water skiing, we feel, is one of the best sports we can work with regularly.
Commander Carton is quite a horse rider. Would you think he'd be undergoing any more strenuous training in American Life or anything?
Well, each of us have our requirements. We're all lined up for flights. Many people feel that just two or three of the fellows are qualified, but we all are candidates for our future space flights, and each of us must keep in top shape.
Do you feel that Commander Carpenter will be making the first manned orbit?
No, I can't answer that, really. I can't say no or yes. We expect to have this announcement shortly, and that we are getting ready for our manned orbital shot.
How much notice is an astronaut usually given?
This is something I can't really answer accurately. We have, on occasion, as you know, sounded like we were announced at the last minute. This is not true. We've known a little bit in advance of that.
Is there anything in the immediate future for you?
Well, we all hope there's something in the immediate future. I seem to be dodging your immediate question, and I really cannot answer it. That's why.
How long do you think you'll be at Mercury?
We'll be here, and why I am here is for our chimp orbital shot.
And when will the chimp be fired in space?
This should be in the middle of next week.
And do you know any date for the first manned shot?
Well, we hope to have it done by the end of December.
Commander, how long will this manned flight last?
Our intention is to orbit for three orbits. This would include an hour and a half to orbit, or a total of 4.5 hours.
And this is the last step before what?
Last step before the next. We don't feel of any last steps. We have the three-orbit mission, and we'll have 18 orbits, four orbits possibly for a week or 2 weeks, all building up toward exploration of man in space and capabilities in space. In addition, we are building up now, as you may be aware from releases, of the lunar mission. This is what we call Project Apollo. We intend to launch three men in a vehicle to go to the moon, land, and return.
Is the moon your primary objective?
It's all of our primary objectives.
Is there any military reason behind it?
We don't think of the space exploration as a military project. This is a research project to develop man's capability in space. I say that once, I say it again, but we don't know what machines we'll see that we can predict. For example, what I'm really trying to say there is that if you have an unknown, you can approach it by hypothetical analysis, but you don't really know what is there. If a machine discovers something that it has never seen before, it cannot be programmed to investigate it. Man, with his capability of thinking and reasoning, if he discovers something new, can analyze it and come up with an answer, a solution, or an investigation.
You don't think that the President's order for an all-out bid to get ready for the Russians had any military implications?
No, I think this might be a national implication, but I don't think it's a military implication.
When do you think the first moon landing could be effected, manned or unmanned?
Well, we, as you probably know, want to do this before the end of the 60s. This would be prior to 1970.
Any plans at all for a base on the moon or perhaps a base in space?
Well, there are many variables that are required for a lunar flight. For example, if we do not have the booster capability for the weight that is required for a lunar orbit and lunar landing and lunar takeoff, we may have to investigate a recovery technique, or as we call it, a rendezvous technique in space. This could be called a space station in a sense. Again, if we find that the mission isn't as reliable as we would expect, we may want to launch something to the moon unmanned, possibly with extra supplies, fuel, oxygen, things that you need for power and for living. This may be sent there before man goes.
Does Russia have any advantage over us at the moment, do you feel?
I feel that we've had a tremendous success recently. Possibly you've heard of our Saturn launching at Cape Canaveral. Saturn is our workhorse for that future exploration in space. Mercury is limited by the low-powered or low-thrusted booster that we're using. With Saturn, we can carry the weights that we need to in orbit to investigate further steps.
What could you possibly say about manned flights in military spaceships?
Well, this area, I'm sure, has to develop. Until man knows what is in space, there shouldn't be any military concept. It should be a research tool that we're working with to find out what is there. For example, if someone came up to the Wright brothers before their first flight and said, what military implications do you have in flight? You wouldn't think of a military implication. If you recall, in the history of aviation, there wasn't a military implication until sometime late in World War I. Well, in the same light, I envision that space itself may eventually have a military implication, but I hope that there isn't one.
What happens if something goes wrong with a chimp's flight?
Well, there are problems that will come up, of course. If something drastically goes wrong with a chimp flight, we've got to fall back and regroup, as our expression is. This means that we have to investigate what the fault was, why we had a failure.
Any other astronauts due to come to Earth?
Yes, we should all eventually come through Earth. The meaning by this that we have our assignments and we rotate through each assignment to become familiar with each area that we will pass over or work with.
How does your wife feel about it? Like all the rest, they're quite happy with your career?
I hope they're happy and they're acclimated to it, meaning that we started out with basic aviation and jet aviation and test piloting and finally this. Each one is a step in an orderly progress, at least to me it's an orderly progress.
What were you doing during Commander Shepard's flight?
At that flight, I was in a chase plane. We have an F-106, which is a supersonic airplane, to be explicit, it's a Mach 2 airplane, and I climbed with Commander Shepard, flying a tight circle around him, up to about 40,000 feet from liftoff. And then at that point, Commander Carpenter, in fact, was at altitude and picked up the booster capsule combination at about 40,000 feet and fell out to sea. Of course, the whole combination made us feel somewhat obsolete.
Do you like the idea yourself of being a space pioneer?
Oh, yes. We're very much impressed with the fact that we have something to contribute, something to explore, something that's new, a new frontier.